So guys, I'm going to convert my current Magento site to PWA, and idea is to duplicate current front end to new PWA design. What I'm going to do is I'm going to override Winia theme to match the current Magento theme. Now before we begin, I need to create a public folder for my assets, for my store assets. Otherwise, PWA Studio uses the Winia static folder to store assets. This was PWA Studio core module, and I don't want to touch any core modules since we need to upgrade the PWA Studio at a later stage. To do that, I'm going to create a new public directory. There is a documentation for changing the static assets directory. Create a public directory in your PWA Studio root and copy all your static assets. Go to manifest.json file and change the data for your website. Next, go to template.html and change the icon links to your new public directory. Next, edit upward.yml file and save it, and then open local intercept.js file. Copy the code in the documentation to local intercept.js. If you like to learn further what are the targets, you can find more details in PWA Studio API reference section or learn event handling in React. After you change local intercept.js and run yarn build, you can see there is an error saying targets not found. This is because in our local intercept, the way we access the targets object is not correct. Modify the code to include targets in your local intercept.js and then run yarn build, and that should fix the issue. Create a components directory in src directory and copy footer, main, app and adapter folders from Winia UI library components. I removed folders and files that I don't need, and let's override the imports. I've already cleaned the file, not the classify library import path. When we override the import, we need to change the path to full path from our footer modification directory. Next, I've changed the app.js in app library, main.js in main directory, and adapter.js in adapter library. And finally, go to index.js in our src directory and change the adapter path to our new adapter location. For CSS, PWA Studio uses TailWind CSS Framework, so we can use the TailWind and CSS module notations for our footer design. I'll add the link to both documentation. Run yarn build and yarn watch and test the footer changes, and you can see the changes are now appearing. Now, so far we have some static changes. I need to call the footer block that I use to show my logo and links from my Magento backend. For this, we are going to use PWA Winia CMS block library. Let's import the library and render it inside our links div element using the identifiers. Build the project and run yarn watch. You can see our footer is now in good shape. That's it for this video. Please like the video and subscribe if you like to get updates on hands-on development with Magento, PWA Studio, and React developments.